Louis Way. I'm getting ready to handle my business.
I'm Beth Switzer. In Florida, you can bet on greyhounds, horses, a high-lie game, and onboard gambling ships called cruises. Where many Floridians know a lot about the gambling industry, even though Class 3 gaming or casino-style gambling isn't allowed in the Sunshine State. In this edition of Florida Crossroads, Krista Brown talks to folks on all sides of the gambling issue about the pros, cons, and a possible gambling expansion. Could Florida win or lose, or will voters draw their own conclusions at the polls?
When the paramutual industry hit big in Florida, it was 1931. Hyatt's racetrack in Miami was king in the Sunshine State, and since then, Florida has worn the crowns of Greyhound Capital of the World, and most recently, King of Hyatt.
Florida is the most diverse paramutual state. We're the only state to operate that offers and operates thoroughbreds, harness, greyhounds, and high-lie.
While Florida isn't Las Vegas or Biloxi, Mississippi, where high-stakes gaming is legal, Florida has more gaming choices than any other state in the country. But it's the game of high-lie that attracts the most attention.
It's basically like tennis. Whoever scores, it just accumulates points. Up until 7 points, and is declared the winner.
Santi Ichanez remembers the sport when movie stars and politicians were crowd regulars.
I started playing here when I was 18 years old, in this particular Fronton, and I just love it. I mean, I grew up learning the game, and I just love it.
The game originated in northern Spain as a form of handball. Players use a handmade basket or cesta made of Spanish oak to throw what is called a pelota at speeds around 150 miles per hour. Right now, Florida is the only state in the nation that allows betting on high-lie. 5 Frontons are in business, and Orlando is the only high-lie to allow amateurs to play the game, too. Hamilton County, near the Florida-Georgia border, is banking on Florida's paramutual industry, expansion or not. In October 2003, a record number of voters gave approval for a high-lie fronton and an off-track betting facility to be built near Jasper, visible from heavily traveled Interstate 75. It is one of the few places where a fronton is built because of mileage requirements between existing facilities.
We vacillate between the poorest and the next to poorest county in the state. We've lost jobs over the last few years. We're slowly losing residents in the county. The only county in the state that is losing residents.
Bob Poor with the Hamilton County Economic Development Council says the county isn't looking to locals to support the paramutual facility, but rather new business and traveling tourists on their way to and from Central Florida.
We're already starting to get jobs. We've got two sets of developers who are looking to build a shopping center anchored by a large chain grocery store. And that's all here in Jasper.
County leaders in Jasper, too, are hoping to see an expansion in Florida's gaming choices with VLTs eventually. But in the state of Florida, it will be a tough sell.
Is it enhancing gambling? Is it an expansion of gambling? The governor, who I work for, is opposed to that idea and the concept of expansion of gambling other than what we currently have here in the state.
I think if it does go to the voters, that they'll reject it as they have in the past.
I think it is inevitable that we will get an increase that we will see VOTs at the track. If we don't get them there, we lose the paramutual industry.
But whether Florida wins or loses on the parimutuel industry is a matter of opinion, and the deciding factor could ultimately remain in the hands of voters, willing to draw a vote for or against the gambling industry that some say is running out of luck.
New card rooms are being built around the state at some existing parimutuel sites because of a 2003 Florida law change. The new law allows poker to be played more often and for more money. County voters still have the final say-so on whether a card room can be built in their area. Thanks for watching. Join us again next time for Florida Crossroads.
Number 25, Diego. Number 11, Ignacio. Thank you.